Welcome to audio video system playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you HDTV high definition television in this session. So to understand high definition television, these are my session outlines.
So first, I'll explain you basics of HDTV high definition television. And then after, I'll give you brief history of HDTV. And then we will see the basic goals which is there with HDTV, and I'll show you how development of HDTV have happened by Eureka as well as by standards of Japan. So in Japan, NHK Musei system that have been deployed, and that is what I'll discuss in detail over here. And after that, I'll explain parameters of HDTV. And at the end, I'll sum up this session by explaining advantages of HDTV. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of HDTV. Now see, transmission of HDTV that is taking place at a 2.07 megapixels per frame. So here, quality of image in video that is at 2.07 megapixels. Per frame. Now see how this 2.07 megapixel is happening. Highest data rate in HDTV that is 1080 pixel. And if you observe this standard for 16:9 ratio, in that case you'll be finding that standard is 1080 into 1920. So if you multiply these two, you'll be finding that is 2.07 into 10 to the power 6. So that is how highest data rate with HDTV is 2.07 megapixels per frame. And in short, we called it like 1080p, means 1080p data rate. P stands for progressive scanning. See, here with HDTV we transmits 5.1 surround sound format, and in HDTV it has been using MPEG-2 video codec for compression of video. And here aspect ratio that can be 16:9 with HDTV. And by having HDTV, it can give service of 35 mm movies with Dolby Digital sound. So see, these are the basic things which is there with HDTV. It is having data rate of 2.07 megapixels per frame with video, 5.1 surround sound system is been there, MPEG-2 video codec is been utilized, aspect ratio is 16:9. Also, it gives services of movies with 35 mm movies with digital Dolby sound system. Now let us see the history which is there with HDTV. See, due to digitization, many digital techniques have been developed in television processing, and that have raised that demand of high definition television. So worldwide leader of HDTV for many years was Japan, and they have developed broadcasting system from Tokyo, and they have used the standard of NHK Musei system. In detail we will see what is NHK Musei system. Europe has started with their own project on HDTV, and that has named Eureka in 1986, and that was used in 32 countries of European region. Now what are the basic goals which is there with HDTV? The major goal that is to improve resolution. See, after basic television system, advancement have started with EDTV, enhanced definition television. In enhanced definition television, there was no change in resolution, but there was change in format of video. And in HDTV, there is improvement in resolution. Previously, we were been having resolution up to 480 pixels only with EDTV, but now in HDTV, 720 as well as 1080 format is there. So that is improved resolution format with HDTV. Second goal is to improve color reproduction. So more number of colors that you will be finding in HDTV, and higher aspect ratio is there. With EDTV, it have already started with improvement in aspect ratio. So it was supporting 4:23 as well as 16:9, but now with HDTV, aspect ratio have increased, and that is 16:9. And the major other fourth goal, that is to have stereophonic sound system. So in HDTV you'll be finding it can even give signal of sound with 5.1 surround sound system. So that was missing with previous system of EDTV as well as normal basic system. So HDTV gives improved resolution, color reproduction, higher aspect ratio, as well as stereophonic sound system with 5.1 surround sound system. Now the development of HDTV. See, Japan have initiated with the standard, and that was having 1125 number of scanning lines per frame initially with 60 fields per second. And also that was having 2:1 interlaced scanning with aspect ratio 16:9. And that have evolved further. And those 1125 lines that were chosen initially to give vertical resolution with 9:5 and 17:5 for PAL with 625 lines, and NTSC with 5:5 number of lines was adopted. So you'll be finding with PAL system there were 625 lines. Right now with this basic standard adopted by Japan, there was 1125 number of scanning lines. So number of lines almost doubled compared to previous system of television, and that was giving higher resolution, right? So that was done by this calibration 9:5 as well as 15:7. And Eureka has done that high definition television standards with 1249 number of scaling lines, and that is, that one can say, almost double of PAL system, and that is more than double of NTSC system. Now NHK MUSE system that was used in Japan. So what is MUSE? MUSE means multiple subcarrier Nyquist sampling encoding, and that was adopted by NHK in Japan, and that is having bandwidth compression scheme. So if you observe, there were 1125 number of lines with interlaced scanning of 60 Hertz. So optimal aspect ratio that was 5:3, and viewing distance was 3.3 height. And if you observe uncompressed luminance bandwidth, then that is 20 megahertz, and uncompressed chrominance bandwidth, that is 7 megahertz. And there have been changes in standard with time, and upgradation was been done. But this bandwidth, 20 megahertz and 7 megahertz, that have been compressed, and that is forwarded on a single channel with 10 megahertz. And even with respect to time, there was upgradation. So you'll be finding nowadays we are using this 1080 progressive scanning type format. So that have came from this only 1125. So that is bit nearer to 1080, you can even see, right? And that is what we are giving it to HDTV by using this DBS system. And Japan have rejected this VSB signal, vestigial sideband, and they have always used this system which is there with MUSE. So that is how the basic history was there with Japan with NHK MUSE system for HDTV. Now let us have basic parameters which is there with HDTV. See, resolution, you can see 720p progressive, 1080p progressive, as well as 1080i interlaced resolution is there. But later on, this 1080i that have been rejected, and this two resolution 720p and 1080p that have been adopted by HDTV. Aspect ratio is 16:9. Pixels per frame, you can see with 4:23 standard, 1280 cross 720 pixel is been there, while for 16:9 standard 1920 cross 1080 that is there. So you can calculate even how much megapixel resolution has been there with one image per frame. And type of scanning, so initially there was interlace scanning by Japan, but later on interlace have been rejected and there was only progressive scanning. Now let us discuss few advantages of HDTV. See, reduced ghost image has been there. It has flicker reduction even. You'll be finding higher resolution of picture by HDTV. Slow motion action is even provided with HDTV. Reduced operational instability has been there with HDTV. And improved reception of fringes areas that one can find. That is.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.